question. I'm Jennifer Hardy from Applause, and after speaking to you at the beginning of the year, I'm here again tonight to thank you for helping to make this year so successful. Our spaghetti dinner was back and better than ever. The historic spring break trip was back and bigger than ever, and we are so thankful to have your contributions to help make a difference in these students' lives. Thank you to the faculty for all of their time and dedication spent both during the day as well as after school away from their own families, like tonight. Thank you to the students who have many extracurricular choices in their schedule, and we are so glad they choose music and have stuck with it these past few years. Thank you to you, the parents, with a special thank you to my fellow board members. It is not lost on us that you have also have choices where you spend both your money and your time. We would love to continue to have your support and have you join us. Before joining Applause, I had little connection to the school other than a drop-off and pick-up. By joining Applause, you can make a difference in the music program here at LFHS, as well as learn about the school, get a glimpse into your students' day, and meet other parents. Congratulations to all for a great year, and best of luck to all the seniors. Congratulations also to the parents of the seniors. They should have their buttons on. And a special shout-out to those parents like me who have their youngest graduating. It's an end of an era. One last thing, we are co-hosting an auction with pals, and we have some great items, and for you senior parents, we have really coveted graduation seats and graduation parking, so please check that out. The link is in the latest Fan Scout, or you can also find it on both Applause's and pals' social media pages. So thank you again, and enjoy the concert.
Kira Carroll on percussion, Arthur Herman on bass, Jack Taylor on guitar, Lily Arenas on guitar, Cohen Brown and Isaac Poulton on trumpet, and Megan Pierce on saxophone.
Also in select singers, tenors, and basses, the soloist in See You Again is Nate Arch, and the soloists in When I Was Your Man are Jonathan Gillison and Raleigh Knoll.
The Pops concert is a very special concert because all the students get to pick the music that we perform. So we're really excited to perform for you some of our favorite pop songs.
And also a quick shout out to Jack Taylor, Kira Carroll, and Yusra Becky for arranging the Foresters arrangement of Copacabana.
Lastly, we'd like to remind you to turn off your cell phones, and if you have to leave the theater, try and wait for in between the songs.
We'd also really quickly like to thank Applause for all their hard work and their help and their support. With that, we hope you enjoy our Pops concert.
Regenerative weapons, and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally. Oh, Too young. Where is Kira? Come out, Kira. Kira, Yusra, and Jack all arranged that piece themselves.
She packed my bags last night, pre-flight, 0:09 a.m.
Oh.
And for the seniors, I do a senior speech, and I thought I would share with everybody what I said about them, because they're such integral parts of the choir culture here, and they're such integral parts of making everybody feel like the choir family matters every day. So I'll talk about Janelle first, because that's what's in front of me. And this is what I said about Janelle. I said, Janelle, so much to say. I feel privileged to have been able to work with you as one of our choir presidents and a leader in Madrigals. As a leader, you're the gentle leader stops and pauses to think about all of our students. You're thoughtful beyond belief, and you constantly try to think about the students we might be missing to make sure they feel included. Maybe hold on to the slideshow. Will you wait 1 second? Brendan, you look great, though. I'm not looking at the slideshow. Everyone's looking great. Janelle, you're special, too. Don't worry. Back to Janelle. Janelle, I think one of the best, my favorite parts of you is that you, every time we meet, you always think, how do we make everybody feel special, especially post-COVID? We've been really trying to make people feel connected. You think about all those little things. For the choir program, I think your mark as president this year would be that everyone felt both you and John, this is the dual one, were incredibly approachable. That the choir program is in a better spot. People feel heard and part of the program. I'm beyond grateful for your hard work, dedication, and constant love in the program. Have made a huge difference in the program. As a musician, you've grown incredibly the past 2 years. You can sing, your voice has opened up, but when you sing, you're so in the moment of the beauty and power of song. It's really inspiring how, like, to watch how you let music move you and how you work to constantly bring it out. On a personal note, I feel lucky to get to know you. Oh, it's like hitting me now that they're really going soon. I feel really lucky to get to know you. You're humble, you're personable. At our weekly meetings, you always ask how I'm doing. You check in, you're unassuming. I think that's so beautiful about you, and wickedly creative without needing attention for great things. I think if people all, like, knew how brilliant you are and creative and just do so many great things, if they really knew that, you don't draw attention to that, and the humility that you bring to that is just beautiful. You left a huge mark in the program, and for me, I can't wait to see what you do in the future. I said the funny things I'm going to remember about you, and I said so, David, this is still so true. When you get overwhelmed or stressed, you just start to have these little laughing fits. And you just sit there and you giggle, just like, wow, this is perfect. Which somewhat happened. Like, when it happens, we all, like, laugh with you, so. We give Janelle a round. John. John also served as our choir president and has been in Madrigals. And was originally a cellist first, right? So he came to the dark side. John is a model artist and student. I wrote John's letter of recommendation, so this is one of the paragraphs I took from it, because I thought I did a nice job, and something really nice in this one. John, you're a model artist and student. You're an expressive musician, you take direction well, you're easy to work with. Unlike many students, when John works on a piece of music or an acting role, John digs deep. He looks at every perspective on the piece of the piece on a large scale, bringing all the intersections of his life to his performances. He practices it in different ways to provide the most meaningful story he can. Because John expects his best, he works tirelessly until he or the director is satisfied. As a musician, John can sight read, has a wonderfully rich bass baritone tone, and is extremely expressive. On top of that, the professionalism and curiosity John brings makes him a student that directors love to work with. You have visualized, you have an end goal, and you consequently your execution is admirable, how you go about it. I'd love to know, getting to know you as a choir president. Similar to Janelle, you're thinking about the team. You think about how we can make memorable experiences memorable. You're a planner. You're a huge planner. You think ahead all the time and you work hard. I wrote specifically, there's a phrase called servant leader. I think you're the servant leader who understands people and brings an extremely mature level of integrity to his work. When John, it's like off script a little bit, when John works with other people, he doesn't ask for attention. He just starts doing it. Everyone follows it because of his kind approach. And it doesn't just start knowing people, it just sort of follows because he wants to be helpful for everybody. I think it's wonderful. On a personal note, I've loved watching to like you loosen up and open up and share about yourself more. And I'm going to miss our weekly meetings. I have no doubt that you're going to be successful in the arts, and I can't wait to see how your journey goes as a musical theater kid. So we'll be seeing you on stage more. So just super excited. Can we give John to run the world? All right, now we're going to bring all the seniors up to stage, and we're going to offer you each a flower from the plaza. But it's also just a moment to just kind of take a second and enjoy the beauty of being a senior, and then we'll talk about all the seniors. So seniors, as I call you up, will you come up to stage and line up? Mrs. Mazza, hand out some flowers to you, and then we'll talk to all of the seniors. So first up is Brendan Arch. And Amir Attar. Connor Boyle. Kira Carroll, Eleanor Coleman, Tom Foley, Melvin Gates, Renee Holloway, Bryce Lankowski, Nico Matura, Hannah McBain, Yusra Mackey, Adam Randall, Shea Scales, Janelle Sherman, Jack Taylor, Grace Thomas, and John Torelli, and Brian Zeman. Buzzwords. You know, super cheesy. I like programmed them to remember those things. For me, I was saying when I was a young teacher, I wanted like two things. Like, my big overarching goals were I want you all to love music for life and be musicians for life. I think that's so important. I think you need music in your life. I think more and more. We say studies show it. Everything you already know, music matters. You have to keep music part of your life. I implore you to keep music part of your life somehow. Join a choir, sing, be part of a cappella, go do something that fulfills you musically. You're wonderful at that. The choir family part of it, that's kind of how we get there. And I think I feel very grateful that you all have taken me in the past years and you've built a choir family over the past years after COVID and after all the changes in personnel and all of the above. I think my favorite part of all of you, and I've said this before, you're all good humans. You are just nice and you build each other up. I have not seen one person turn and belittle anybody in this group who hasn't been there to build each other up. When things happen that are hard, you look at each other and you acknowledge one another and you go with the flow. I think it's so beautiful how you're this class specific. I've taught 13 years. I've never had a class where, I guess you'd say this, drama-free. But you really are. You're just wonderful people, and I think that because of that, you guys have set a culture up whole program where people are expected to just be friendly and to be open and easy and to be who they want to be, which I think is even more admirable. I wish you all the luck, and I hope you know your choir family is always here. You better come back and visit Mrs. Ma and myself. Where's Mrs. Ma? Oh, there she is. Because we all want to know what your future looks like and we want to see what you're doing. So without further ado, can we give our class of choir seniors a And now we get to actually watch the slideshow. Yay, turn around. Let's look at it. I think the people we have to thank next in honor, and seniors especially, all the parents of seniors, will you stand real quick? Parents of seniors. I think we're honored as parents. I have a 10-year-old and 8-year-old, and I keep laughing. Every night we have something of the week. Every night it's baseball practice, or piano, or softball, and then she wants violin now, and all of the above. And I think from preschool shows, to rehearsals, to singing in the house, to listening to the choir drama, you guys have been awesome supporters of the arts in the choir program, and specifically your seniors. So seniors, I want you to give your parents a round of applause for being awesome and being able to do that. Thank you, parents. Some final thanks before our last two songs, and we do have a final dedication. Thanks to our administration. We're super grateful for all of you. We appreciate you just being here and supporting us. And we have to give a thanks to, where's Mama Ma? Get over here. This is a gem of a human and musician, and we are beyond lucky every day to have her in our life. So you guys are so blessed, I guess the best way to say it, to have this talented, wonderful person as a mama and a best friend of Tommy. So. And my last one is my thank you to all the students. But what other profession do I get to sit there and make music with amazing people every day? So students, I just want to say thank you to you for making Mrs. Vaughn our job fulfilling every day. And we are grateful to you and you, that you're part of the choir family, and we love you so much. So thank you, students, for all that. So.
After all of this, thank you, Mr. Rhea. I just want to thank you because you just do so much for all of us, and for everyone that doesn't know, like, it hasn't exactly been the smooth road the past 4 years. Like, a lot of us have had 3 different choir teachers in 4 years, which is kind of crazy. And I feel like I think back to your first day last year, junior year, and there was kind of just a shift in the energy in the choir program, where I know I've met some of my very closest friends, like, after COVID, coming back and just you providing us here a space to sing and just become so close. That's just such a wonderful gift. So I just want to thank you for that. And also, I don't know where Mrs. Ma is, but you have just been such a wonderful and constant guiding light for me these past 4 years. There's not many people I can say that about, and just I know I can always go to you for guidance or anything. So I just want to thank you for playing for me so many times, just being a wonderful friend.
Mrs. Ma, I know a bunch of us stuck with choir because of you and your smiling face and all your joy. And Mr. Regale, you've given all of us a great 2 years so far, and we're super excited to keep in contact, I know as seniors, and see what happens with our choir program. So thank you.
All right, two last songs. Janelle's going to conduct a little blessing for the end of the year for our seniors.